How you doing, man?
How you doing, man?
Fish taco. I hear they're
fish
good
taco.
Here.
Yeah. Well, let's have some fish taco.
I've never had a real Mexican fish taco, believe it or not.
I came here to meet you, to have a few tacos with you. And I remember that my father used to take me here.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, 20 years ago. Suddenly, I have a huge 25, 20 years flashback. When I was around 12, 13 years old, my father used to take me here on weekends. We travel from Tijuana here. We have some tacos and a shrimp cocktail.
68 miles south of Tijuana, the road takes you to Ensenada, a busy commercial port, cruise ship destination, home of the famous fish taco. But the road takes Octavo, my new local friend, on an unplanned detour.
There's another thing about food. It can take you places in time. You can travel with taste.
No doubt about it. There seems to be a kind of a consensus that this place serves a really damn good one.
I believe they're right. I mean, I believe it's true. Well, Marta has been here for about 26 years now. Fish taco became popular on the 50s. People of Ensenada started cooking it with a batter, made with beer and some spices.
What kind of fish? Shark.
Shark.
Shark's a good idea. It's nice and meaty. So it just totally build your own. You get fish in a tortilla, and then you dress it yourself.
Some people use lettuce, but the traditional.
But traditionally, you think cabbage. You use the lime?
Yeah, for sure. Here's some salsa. It's called bandera because of the colors, red, white, and green.
Bandera, flag, right?
Flag. Cream, yeah. Mayonnaise and cream.
All right.
Probably guacamole.
Yeah, whoa, what's that?
Chipotle. Yeah. Cheers, man. This is a very tasty batter.
Wow, that's good. I feel embarrassed saying this, but this is unlike anything I've had before.
Good memories here. Good memories. The flavor can take me there 20 years back. It's quite a good feeling.
I'm a little surprised. You know, this place is like world famous. I didn't expect to find it next to like a Chanel boutique.
I mean, yeah. Oh man.
I've been hearing about this place for ages. Many say it's the best street cart in the world. Javier, a local restaurateur, shows me to an unimposing-looking cart on a corner. You wouldn't know anything special about it at first glance, other than maybe the unusually large selection of brightly colored salsas and garnishes on the counter. And the crowd of blissed-out looking locals.
Defined for those who don't know, tostada is a flat toasted tortilla.
Correct.
With stuff on top.
Well, the stuff is on top. Only seafood here. They have a famous tostada with clam and sea urchin.
Sea urchin and clam sounds really good. What do you recommend here? Should I be putting sauce on this?
Yeah.
Wow. They are not messing around here, are they? Wow, that's really good.
On a spread of fresh sea urchin. Pismo clam, a wash of lime, chili sauce, avocado, toasted peanuts with garden chilies.
It's like the Bernardin-quality seafood in the street. Wow, sauce is good too. Whoa. Wow.
Fresh scallop and sea snail. Fresh purple onion. A dash of sea salt, a splash of lime, more chili sauce.
Woo, it's good. I mean, it's shockingly good.
A thick slather of salt cod with olives, onion, tomato, chiles, and abuelita sauce made from chile guajon.
It's intensely pleasurable. And she dresses it really well. It's got just enough heat. All right, one last one. Pulpo.
Octopus. Diced and placed on a pillow of red snapper ceviche, lime and salt. Squeeze of chili sauce. Avocado.
Is that a right or what?
A right? You know, how do you describe this for an audience? The delicate interplay between crunch and acid, freshness and spice.
Buenísimo, eh? Buenísimo, eh? Buenísimo.
Really, this is some sophisticated food here. This woman is a genius. If you want to know what I really think, be sure to check my website at travelchannel.com.
Hey, I got lobster, grilled fish, fried fish, oysters, clams, spreader shrimp, and the garlic, and the butter, la diabla, cucaracha, taro, red chupillo, catfish, tacos, shrimp, tacos, ceviche, tostadas, fish, and shrimp.
Zigzagging up the coast from Ensenada, Ivan and I reach the fishing village of Popotla.
The kind of people here is really, like, local. We cannot get more Mexican.
The town originally grew up to serve the needs of a nearby film studio, where they shot some movie I frankly hated. But now that Hollywood's gone, it's become a place for local families to spend an afternoon by the beach and enjoy some amazing, amazing seafood.
This is a great place. You want something, like, real fresh, some oysters. Clams.
Oh, it is crab season now?
Yeah.
Oh, good. And lobster too, right?
And lobster too, yeah.
Yeah, that's a tough call. Maybe we should get both.
Yeah, that should be cool, right?
Pick almost any of the stands, sit down with a beer, and wait till they bring in the catch of the day. You won't be sorry.
Oh, yeah. I love this place. Look at that. That is a big lobster. Whoa. And a big crab. Perfecto.
The lobster is a Puerto Nuevo style. You want it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
I don't even know what Puerto Rico style is, but I want it.
Yeah, and it's very good.
Named after a nearby town, Puerto Nuevo style basically means chop the sucker up and throw it in a hot oil. Simple, delicious. Serve with rice, beans, and tortillas, and you're good to go.
All right.
Now this is a good day in paradise. Beautiful.
Mm. Wow.
That's delicious and tender for such a big. Usually, a lobster this big, they start getting tough.
Yeah.
Mm. Can't lay off those beans and rice, man. It's awesome.
They're great, right?
I really wanted that.
And if one giant sea creature is not enough, why not have another?
Mm. Damn, look at that. Wow. Still out of a monster movie big. Look at this. Jesus, that's enormous.
This is like a returning to like the primitive ways to eat, no?
Yeah, right. The tearing apart with your hands. Look at all this stuff in the knuckle. It's outrageous. Yeah, that's where the good is buried. in there. You really got to work for it. But yeah, there you go. I knew you were in there. I knew. You're so sly, but so am I.
I like the cannibal part of it. Like,
oh yeah. Mmm. Whoa, that's good. Picked clean. Wow. Some nature's bounty right there.
So these are gonna be in a very beautiful, nice nap.
Oh yeah. We did good here today.
Inland from the coast, El Valle de Guadalupe, Mexican wine country. Here, like in Tijuana, chefs are moving things forward, pioneering what's been referred to as Baja Med. Look around. It feels like Tuscany.
Here, the microclimate is similar to the Mediterranean.
Right.
But I don't like the quote of like a small like Baja Med. I mean, we're a lot more Mexican than Mediterranean. I mean, it's Mediterranean ingredients used in a Mexican way.
And though Baja Med may be something of a misnomer, one thing is for sure. No better guy to show you around than Benito Molina, chef of the very famous Ensenada restaurant Manzanilla and host of a popular TV show.
This is a very different Mexico. I mean, you can go for miles and miles and not see anything.
So it should be just like, you know, a discovered paradise.
Benito's brought me here, a vineyard and restaurant space, Corazón de Tierra, to introduce me to the work of a protege of his, Chef Diego Hernandez. He's working hard at creating menus and dishes that are to the greatest extent possible 100% Baja.
He's a very talented young guy, and he works a lot with the local ingredients.
This is roasted tuna belly.
Wow.
Roasted tuna belly, daikon garnish, kohlrabi, nasturtium, mizuna, and lemon oil.
So this is delicious.
Yeah.
The seafood here is just mind-blowing.
The best bluefin in Mexico comes from here, too.
You have really just shockingly good raw ingredients.
Exactly. I think that's like the core of the Baja scene, or what we're trying to do, is the ingredient. No? Ingredient is the showcase.
Black bean braised leg of lamb with Swiss chard, carrot, radish, and turnip.
Oh, that, see now, that's very, very, very interesting to me. That's pretty. The food's awesome, this is delicious.
Yeah, fantastic. And the vegetable from the garden. The borraja, just try one by itself. It has this oyster taste. So you can do this like vegetable dish with oyster taste.
This was really interesting dish. It had a sort of a Michel Bra, Charlie Trotter presentation, but with Mexican all style. Mexican ingredients and all Mexican flavors. So let me ask you something. That all of the chefs you chose to apprentice with or work with, Mexican chefs.
Yeah.
You didn't go to France or New York.
Never.
Do you think there's going to be a new generation of Mexican chefs and Mexican cooking?
Yeah, I think so. I think that it's very important for us as young chefs to get to know our own cuisine, and then you can start thinking what you want to do.
Extraordinary meal, chef. Thank you.
Thank you.
Really, really enjoyed it. It was great.
Gracias. Con permiso.
It's interesting, though. He clearly knows French technique, but his Jedi masters were all Mexican.
Mexico, exactly.
That's kind of cool. You probably wouldn't have seen that 10 years ago.
No, I had never thought about it that way. You're absolutely right. And that also tells you a lot about how the technique and the whole food scene in Mexico has evolved.
The possibilities here are just so ridiculous.
It's like we have a clean slate here. Baja is the youngest state in Mexico. And since it's so new, I mean, there is everything to be done or discover. We can do whatever we want.
To Baja?
Placer. To Baja.
There's a place where men are free. Free to ride. From here all the way down the 1,000-mile Baja coastline if you want. But today, maybe just back and forth. Or up in the air a little bit.
What? 30 feet?
Chef Luis Tucker and his fellow ambassadors of the off-the-road community have put together a little beach party.
It's big toys for big boys. That's what I say.
So some nice beach parties you throw here, like the squeeze bottle cilantro sauce. Is everybody a gourmet in this country?
Just another day at the beach, you know?
We start with charcoal-grilled oysters still in the half shell.
Got some kumamotos and some pacificas. And I love the oysters. I mean, they're from a really salty part of Baja.
We got that good cold water here, right? Comes down from Alaska, exactly. Comes up here.
Good salty taste.
I'm going in.
And this is a little piloncillo sauce here with a chipotle and caramelized onion.
Mm. These things grill up so well. They get really almost buttery.
And we also got a bluefin tuna.
Beautiful.
There's both grilled and not. And both with more salsa options.
Mmm.
Beautiful.
That works. What's going on with the food here? I mean, the food around here is really amazing. Everywhere I've gone, I've been getting like these craft beer, you know, sushi grade tuna, amazing world class oysters, and this lady is selling like Michelin quality food out of a sweet cart. It's like the Napa Valley, only better.
And with that, I ride, my friends. Forget. Most of us don't even know about this amazing microclimate just south of San Diego. Another Napa right beneath our noses. Okay, Mexico is a country with some big problems, but they're our neighbor. If you think about it, our relationship with Mexico, however reluctant, is in many ways a lot closer and a lot more intimate and romantic than we have even with Canada. And I don't know if the determination of a few young chefs and musicians who've decided to make the most of a bad situation will in the end save the world. I don't know if incredible ingredients and an exciting emerging culinary scene will help turn things around for Baja. But if there's any justice in the world, it should.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12. 13, 14, 15, 16, 20. That's a tequila mug, not tequila chat.
We'll be right back. Never. Sitting here in this chair, drinking some beer.
Thus comes to a close our enchanting week in Baja.
It was awesome, but this morning, a blistering hangover.
Mr. Tequila hurt me. I heard rumors of a coffee. Would that be a forlorn hope? Insert hangover joke here.
No better tonic than a totally over-the-top Mexican breakfast. A mountain of rice, beans, tortillas, and chicken.
Oh, wow. Good Lord, that's big. Holy crap. Ah, that's just what I want when I'm hung over a bowl of bugs. Move them over there. Not helping with Mr. Head. Let the magic begin. Good. I feel better. I feel ready to walk out that door and face the challenges of the day anew.
And since we pretty much summed up what I think about this place in the last act,
music swells, camera pulls back, and here come the titles.
Antonio era un hombre prohibido.